My name is Felicia. I'm 47. I'm from Detroit. And I have a huge lump on my forehead. It's kind of soft at the top, but then it's hard right in the center.
I wish this thing would come out. It's so hard and it's so big. And it won't actually bust at the same time.
Well, I've had the lump about 3 years. It started out as a small lump underneath the skin. So I decided I'll just bust it. A little liquid came out of it, very clear, and that's when it just went downhill from there. Because I pick with it all the time, constantly. And the more I pick it, the darker it gets.
It looks worse every time I look at it, and it looks darker.
But that still doesn't stop me from messing with it.
These are my wigs.
I have multiple wigs. I have them in different colors, but they all have to have a bang to it. I have to constantly check my bangs to make sure no one can see my lump. Now you can see my lump, and now you can't. Voila. I used to take a lot of pictures with my natural hair, showing more of my face, which includes my forehead. And I would submit the pictures to be an extra in movies. But I know that the lump on my forehead is not something a casting director would want to see. If I don't wear a wig with bang, I'm not going to get hired for the job. So that's a big problem.
Hey, Mom.
Hey.
What's going on?
How are you?
Me and my mom live together. We're very close. And she's the number one person that is concerned about the lump.
It's starting to look like a gunshot.
Oh, my God. It's not a gunshot. It's a lump.
You're just being really stubborn about this whole thing.
What if I get the surgery and it makes me look worse?
When I went to the dermatologist, they didn't really seem like they knew what they were doing. And if something was to go wrong, the lump is in the center of my head. So if the right doctor doesn't take it out, it can go from worse to worse.
You can't go by the what ifs. It's something that you just got to do. Because this is not living the way that you want to live.
If Dr. Lee can remove this lump from my forehead, then I can just get my life back and feel free again. Felicia, I'm here to see Dr. Lee.
Well, Felicia, we're gonna go ahead and take your temperature.
I am so excited to be here in California. I'm just gonna keep my hopes high and hope that she can get in and pop this baby out. But at the same time, I'm real nervous. I could end up with a scar. I feel that it's a possibility that she can't remove as much of the scar discoloring as I want. That really gives me fear. Fear, fear, fear.
Felicia,
hello.
Is that you?
Yes.
Welcome to California.
I know, yay, I'm happy.
Okay, I'm gonna take off my mask.
Okay. Okay.
So I guess I can see why you're here. Tell me the story, how long have you had this?
I've had about like 3 years. At first it was just like a bump underneath the skin.
Okay.
So then I was like, okay, well, I'll just pop it.
So you went in the bathroom and you started
this,
squeezing? Okay.
Thinking that
squeezing
I was
hard.
Getting
okay.
somewhere with that. And it didn't bust, you know? And then it's darkening mm-hmm. and everything.
The darkening of Felicia's skin on her forehead is really caused by her. I mean, it's caused by her picking at it, scratching at it. The area darkens, and the larger it gets, the more difficult it is to remove this completely. I need a closer look before I can really decide if this is something that is feasible.
Well, there is definitely something under there.
Yeah.
I'm not sure exactly what it is. If I were to guess, it's more like a lipoma.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this bump on top is definitely prurigo, what we say a prurigo or a picker's nodule.
Okay.
It's just something that's been manipulated. It almost looks like a little nipple. You know what I mean?
Oh, wow.
You know, I mean, the point of it, because it
yeah.
kind of like bulges up on the
yeah.
top. I'm just trying to see whether we could like reasonably remove this little raised growth here and have enough room to move things around. And I think we can. I mean, it's close, but I think we can.
The crucial decision here, really, in removing this really nipple is to remove just enough of it that I can pull the skin edges closed. I have to excise enough tissue so that there's no remnant of this, but I don't want to remove so much that I can't close this properly.
Okay, so I'm gonna get all ready for you.
Okay.
And we'll bring you back in just a bit.
Thank you. I'll see you soon.
Okay.
I made my bump have a very dark discoloring because I kept picking with it.
We're gonna bring you inside now.
So now, really, Dr. Lee got two issues to deal with, the lump on my forehead and how to get my skin back to its original color.
I'm gonna put some numbing in there and then we'll see what's under there. I still don't even know what's under there. Doing okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Again, you shouldn't feel anything other than us touching you.
Okay.
Nothing should be sharp or uncomfortable.
My goal always on the face is to remove as little normal skin as possible, leaving you with the smallest scar. In Felicia's case, she's got this large darkened area on her skin. I'm trying to remove as much of that as I can, but there's still gonna be dark skin remaining. The only way that this darkened skin is gonna lighten up is with time. And so she's gotta keep her hands off of it.
Turn that little bit in. So initially one can see how thickened the scar is. Right here, the skin is very thick because it's been kind of just scratched, rubbed on all the time. Let's just see if I can get to it now. Still, because the skin, like I said, is thick.
As I'm cutting through it, I notice that it's really thick, that tissue, and it's hard for me to even get down to whatever it is under there. Do I have to make a wider incision? Will I be able to stitch this up?
Maybe it's a cyst, so keep your eyes open. Nope, lipoma.
It's a lipoma.
Yeah.
I finally reached the lump, and it does turn out to be a lipoma, but it was hard to get to because the skin on top was so thick, she has really picked at this area. It is the thickest forehead skin I've ever seen.
See, imaging right there? Oh, he's a cute one. You got a cute one under there.
Oh, wow.
You okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's a pretty one, actually. I have to tell you. It doesn't often come out in one piece, but that one did, I do believe.
Probably be like a little scar line hidden along your forehead line there.
Okay.
It'll still be dark around it because I'm not removing that whole dark area.
Okay.
So with time, like everything else, just keeping your hands off of it will help it to fade out.
Okay.
I was able to remove Felicia's adorable lipoma and much of that darkened nipple on her forehead. It was a challenge because I had to leave some of the darkened tissue. So it really is important that she keeps her hands off of it. With time, it will look really good.
Guess what, he's gone.
Okay, here you go. Here's that little nipple I took off. And this is the thing that was under there. It's cute.
Ooh, that looked disgusting.
It's like a little piece of shrimp. Fried shrimp.
It's like a circus going on my forehead. A little shrimp, a little nipple, a little liquid. So now that the party's gone from my forehead, I'm ready to party.
When we stop rubbing it, I think that's gonna come down too. So it's just gonna take a little longer for that to fully flatten.
I cannot believe I waited so long to get the lump out of my forehead. It's unbelievable, but I'm so happy that it has now happened.
Oh, God, I feel like crying. Thank you so
much.
Oh, my God, I feel like a new person already.